the surprise two from Canada that also made it through, but you can see both these pair, 1-2, lost one, and I watched Tianqing and Zhao Yunlei. I don't think you were with me for that match against Peterson and Rutuyul, and they were outsmarted. They were outgunned, if you like, because the Danes threw everything at them and they couldn't handle it. But we know, watching also Chen Wen-Sing and her partner Qian Yu-Chin, that they do have one disadvantage with the service. Qian Wen-Sing has struggled with the serve, and that could be so important up against such a strong pairing.
Yeah, it's vital, and double serve, return and third shot are considered the three most important shots in doubles. So if you're struggling on your serve, it's of huge significance. And there is Qian Yu-Chin, 29-year-old. Actually won a bronze medal in the World Championships in mixed doubles 2 years ago in Paris. And of course, with her partner here in the women's doubles, Chen Wen-Sing, won a bronze medal at those same World Championships in the women's doubles. Well, it is the pair from Taipei who have been world number ones, which is something that Tianqing and Zhao Yunlei can't lay claim to yet.
I like the way you put the yet. They haven't been together that long, have they?
No, and since they formed their partnership, which was the same time as Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang formed their partnership, you know, they have quite clearly been the two outstanding pairs in the world, but of course the pair that's been disqualified, Wang Xiaoli and Yu Yang, have been more successful than this Chinese pair. So they've, ever since they've really started playing together, as soon as they played enough tournaments to get a realistic world ranking, they've been at number two, and they've stayed at number two.
But they've been maybe the more impressive pair this year.
Yep, I would totally concur with that. Three titles.
Here's the Danish umpire, Christian Johannesson.
Very positive start from Chen Wen-Sing.
Interesting they're wearing the black outfit tonight. Not often I comment on fashion states here, but of course they had it in a match a couple of days ago. They wore white. Yesterday they wore black. And they were asked how they decided it. Now Chien says, against Fujin Kakawa, they had a game of rock, scissors, paper, and she won. She chose black. She's obviously won again tonight.
Oh, that's landed in. Taipei really are very, very good. They get Chen Wen-Sing forward to the net as much as possible, and her reading of the game and her racket skills, her disguise at the front. Oh, superb. And I think we'll see them try and get in that formation as much as possible. There's Chin, Yu Chin's power from the back of the court, allowing her partner to go forward. Run out of patience in the end. Chen Yuqin. Goodness gracious! Well, she completely mishit that.
But it's still, a winner.
Still went over.
I think it was more the wind speed of the from the racket head than the racket head's connection with the shuttle that got it over. But there you go. Taste of the problems with the chin. Didn't seem to serve that. Start. I'm not just talking about the scoreline, but just in terms of the rallies. Not much to choose between them. Nationalities starting the quarterfinals of these women doubles, of course. We now announce Russians, Canadians, and Japanese through. There's the two of the strongest pairs left then. And, a bit of an advantage open up by the Chinese too.
Oh, goodness me, how did she control that? A full stretch. Wonderful. Into the mid-game interval. Oh, no, not quite yet. I'm jumping ahead of myself.
Won't be long. Thank you.
she left right and it landed a long way in. Tian Qing.
Well, there is the interval, 11-7. Very good start from Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei. Decisive one for the world number two pair. How's that little, you can see the blue coming through the back of her shirt there. See, to protect her back. It doesn't look inhibited though.
No, in fact, an awful lot of the Chinese players do wear these back supports, and it's just a precaution rather than knee injury worry. It's a bit like their knee bandages, they always wear those too.
Looks like part of the outfit, doesn't it, really? both on their right knees. In fact, you can't quite see them because they're almost matched the colour of their skin, but those Chinese Taipei girls are bandaged up as well. Quite heavily too.
Just long. Well, it's been a bit of a trend in sport that you should wear bandages that are bright pink or bright blue or something. It's quite a rarity now to.
Don't want to spoil the outfits, obviously.
No.
There you go.
Yep.
Got a better view of it there.
Play from the front of the court from Chen Wensing, completely jamming her opponent. Taipei players will be a little bit concerned about the body language after that rally.
With by Zhao Yunlei there, who's into the semis, isn't she, also of the mixed doubles. A bit Danish pair this morning, her and Zhang Nan.
more. Chinese players just absolutely pounce on anything that's short.
I've got to say, given the way they played yesterday, it's like they've been given a proverbial kick up the backside. It's like they're saying they're not going to be overpowered today.
Did they look a little complacent yesterday when they went onto court?
I didn't think they necessarily looked complacent. I just thought Pedersen and Rutuyo just played
absolutely too good.
Brilliantly.
Yeah.
Just didn't allow them to get going at all.
Facing in a downward direction. Service judge from Indonesia.
And then Sukarja.
Deceptive and so clever.
They've got a little mixed bag, haven't they? Cheng and Jian. Three games it took to beat Sarashin Demilion Yale on Saturday. Then they lost to Honapur and Gudu of India, but they bounced back with a very impressive win over the Japanese pair, Kakiwa and Fuji, who we know are already into the semi-finals yesterday. They absolutely demolished them in straight games. So seeing a bit of everything from them, and today it's been a little bit of everything, some brilliance and at times just moments where they just don't seem to be in the match at all. Ching and Zhao Yunlei here. Very impressive so far from them. Well, hasn't taken long, has it? 15 minutes. Yeah, thereabouts to polish off that first game. 21 points to 10. Right now, hard to see how this game is going to change momentum, really.
No, I guess the only thing that's possibly work in the favour now of the Taipei pair is the change in drift, because there's a big difference in the speed of the shuttle from one end to the other, because there's a slight air current in this. And that does move the shuttle. The shuttle is terribly light in badminton, and therefore only a little bit of drift in the arena, and the front of the shuttle is affected. And perhaps the Taipei pair can start to command the net a little bit more. Perhaps the attacking play go down a little quicker. But that said, did think that the Chinese pair looked so solid in all departments of their game.
Yeah, and in an ironic way, the disqualification of their teammates could be something of a boost for them, because now they are the number one pair. They're the possible golden girls. was Wu Yang, who was defending her title, wasn't she?
Yeah. On the women's doubles in Beijing, playing with Du Jing.
So can Chen Wenxing and Chen Yuqin here just turn things back their way? I suppose they can relax into this game a little more. They need to somehow get their noses in front of the start of the second game.
Looks as if she maybe changed her mind there, Chen Wenxing. And it's landed in.
It's been right on the line. The serve, weren't they, there? Gas there from that exchange. Again, the dominance at the net.
Yeah, and the Taipei pair aren't really challenging her at all. I think if you are going to beat this Chinese pair, I think you really have to get Zhao Yunlei away from the net, push her to the back of the court, and make her defend. Just too good at the front.
And the way this second game started, I think it's, like I say, it's been more of the same to it.
Yeah, it's the problem for the Taipei pair is the fact that they've never beaten their opponents of today, and I think psychologically now, having lost the first, they would have of course gone into the match believing they could win, especially after the fact that Xiao Yunlei and Tian Qing lost against the Danes. That would have given the Taipei pair a huge boost, and they'd say, yes, we can win this. But when you've gone a game down and you've lost to this pair previously, never beaten them,
never taken a game,
It plays on your mind. As much as the psychologists will tell you that put that out of your mind, in your subconscious, it's still there.
Well, the way things are going, it's an intriguing semi-final lineup, to say the least. And of course, we know part of the reason for that. Four players disqualified. Four new players returning. Delightful, wasn't it? Sometimes you just have to say you're beaten by the better pair. And at the moment, it's been pretty flawless badminton from Zhao Yunlei and Tian Jing here.
Kept Zhao Yunlei away from the net.
Tight call, and he's given in. Badminton champions, England champions, also won the Korean Open this year, the Chinese pair.
Yeah, that was their first three tournaments of the year.
Did lose the final of the Singapore Open to Wang Xiaoli and Wu Yang.
Four individual tournaments this year and four finals, winning four of them. That's pretty impressive, isn't it?
Just a bit, yeah. And you would fancy, should they get there, to get the better of the Russian pair as well and make another final.
Looked almost over-eager to get forward. Look, she plays this smash and she's already trying to look to come forward, and that's perhaps why she made the error.
Well, point in it now in this game. Now, what can she do with her serve here? Can she play the flick serve?
It's a shocking low serve.
It was neither, was it?
No.
See whether Wang Xiaoli and Wu Yang are allowed to stay around the camp as Tian and Zhao go to an 11-7 interval lead here. Because of course they would be pretty useful practice partners. World number two pair, wouldn't they, Joe?
Yeah, they certainly would. Mind you, I think most of the Chinese coaching staff are former World or Olympic champions and would be pretty good sparring partners for them.
The Danes are out. Some very young, some not so young. Been a few Danes in action tonight at Wembley Arena. Focus on the badminton, but I have a feeling that once these players finish their matches, they'll be asked a lot of questions about what's been going on rather than just making the semi-finals. And then in the rallies like this, Xian and Cheng, they look a terrific pair. Getting into those rallies though.
A slight confusion. I think they left it for the other. Yeah, you see, this is Zhao Yunlei. So typical of her. She was trying to come forward to the net instead of staying at the back of the court and hitting another smash. And that's what the Taipei pair need to try and exploit.
There for two Chinese players.
This is getting very interesting.
3 points in a row.
Play from Qian Yuqin. My goodness, she doesn't usually go forward like that, but took the initiative. And all of a sudden, they're back level.
And suddenly, they're in a match again. The inevitable. It doesn't always happen, you know. Get ahead though, did they?
The yell of delight at winning that round. I think it went up a couple of decibels, didn't it?
Yeah.
Well, what's she going to do on her serve?
Time over this, isn't she?
I think I'd be tempted just to put in a high serve. Not a flick. Serve forehand, serve high, so that you've got time to settle in your defensive position and then try and build the rally from there. Quite low serve. Flick is giving her no advantage.
No one really serves forehand, do they? It's what a good it does. It's about it, really.
Yeah. Oh, that's a good rally.
Flicker of hope wasn't there for Chen Wensing and Jian Yujin.
Psychology of it, because you get your hopes up because you've drawn back level and then all of a sudden you've got a 4-point deficit again and it's a real uphill battle. But 4 points can be closed quite easily in doubles.
4 points there is all that's required as well for Patrick.
Yep.
It's been a classy display from these Chinese girls. They're not directly caught up in what's been going on. I'm sure they've been very much aware of what's been happening. To be mentally strong, don't you?
Oh, that's a good play from Tian Qing. I think sometimes we forget is just how good she is, because it's usually her partner that finishes off the rally, which of course looks spectacular, so we sing the praises of Xiao Yunlei, but Tian Qing so often is building the rally, setting her partner up, and on that occasion hit the winner herself.
I know I should know the answer to this question, but has anyone come away with 2 gold medals in 1 Olympics in badminton?
No.
I'm just thinking, of course, Xiao Yunlei has a distinct chance, hasn't she yet?
She does indeed. The best that's happened so far is a gold and a silver.
Number one seeds in the mixed doubles as well, she is. Going on a while, yeah. Oh! Anyone on that court. The match points have arrived for Tian Qing and Xiao Yunlei. brilliant performance from the world number two pair. They completely outclassed their opponents. Comprehensive victory. And into the semi-finals go Tian Qing and Zhao Yunlei. 21-10, 21-14. They're the pair to beat.